assurance, Jesus is mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine, heir of salvation, purchase of God, born of His Spirit, washed in His blood. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story, this is my song,
is my trumpet of the Lord shall sound, and time shall be no more, and the morning breaks eternal bright and fair. When the saved of earth shall gather over on the other shore, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the roll
is called up yonder, I'll be there.
Called up yonder, I'll be there.
When the roll
is called up yonder, when the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. On that bright and cloudless morning, when the dead in Christ shall rise and the glory of his resurrection share, when his chosen ones shall gather to their home beyond the skies, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there.
When the roll
is called up yonder, I'll be there.
When the roll
is called up yonder, I'll be there.
When the roll
is called up yonder,
when the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there.
Called up yonder, I'll be there.
I'll be there.
Spread the sky, but when traveling day days are over, not a shadow, not a sigh.
When we all
get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be.
When we all
see Jesus, we'll sing and shout the victory.
Trusting, serving every day.
Just one glimpse of Him in glory will the toil of life repay.
When we all
get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be.
When we all
see Jesus, we'll sing and shout the victory.
Onward to the prize before us, soon His beauty we'll behold.
Soon the pearly gates will open, we shall tread the streets of gold.
When we all
get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be.
When we all
see Jesus, we'll sing and shout the victory.
Blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine. Heir of salvation, purchase of God, born of His Spirit, washed in His blood.
This is my story. This is my song. Praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story. This is my song.
Love.
This is my story.
when peace like a
river. Yeah. Jesus said, I am the resurrection and I am the life. He who believes in me, though he die, yet shall he live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His compassion never fails. Every morning they are renewed. Jesus said, let not your heart be troubled. Believe in God and believe also. I am sure that neither death nor life, nor angels nor principalities nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus, our Lord. He lives, we live to the Lord, and if we die, we die to the Lord. So then, whether we live or whether we die, we are the Lord. For to this end, Christ died and lived again, that he might be Lord both of the dead and of the living. We brought nothing into the world, and we take nothing out. The Lord gives and the Lord takes away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Eternal God is our refuge, and underneath are the everlasting arms. We stand. With faith in Jesus Christ, we receive the body of our sister, Fay Antoinette, for burial. Our sister was washed in holy baptism and anointed with the Holy Spirit. Let us therefore, with confidence, pray to God, our Heavenly Father, the giver of life, that he will raise her to perfection in the company of the saints. The Lord be with you.
Also with you.
Let us bow our heads in prayer. O God of grace and of glory, we remember before you this day our sister Faye Antoinette. We pray, we thank you for giving her to us, her family and friends, to know and love as a companion on our earthly pilgrimage. Your boundless compassion, console us who mourn. Give us faith to see in death the gate of eternal life, so that in quiet confidence we may continue our course on earth until by your call we are reunited with those who have gone before through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Rest eternal grant to her, O Lord. May her soul and all the souls of the faithful departed, through the mercies of God, rest in peace. Amen. We join and sing the opening hymn, To God Be the Glory.
And I saw the holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a low voice.
You're going to have to reset your voice. And this is how you introduce me. Just wait. You can raise your voice. Mm. Go ahead and read that.
A reading from the Word of God.
You sure you can make it or you want me to read it?
I can finish it, man. Taken from the book of Revelation, chapter 21, verses 2 to 7. And I saw the holy city from. And I saw the holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a low voice from the throne saying, "Behold, the dwelling of God is with men. He will dwell with them, and they shall be his people. And God himself will be with them. He will wipe away every tear from their eyes, and death shall be no more. Neither shall there be mourning, nor crying, nor pain anymore. For the former things have passed away," and he who sat upon the throne said, "Behold, I made all things new." Also he said, "Write this, for these words are trustworthy and true." And he said to me, "It is done. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. To the thirsty I will give from the fountain of the water of life without payment. He who conquers shall have this heritage, and I will be his God, and he shall be my son." Here is the reading.
We stand now for the chanting of Psalm 23, the Cremon version, and during the singing of the last verse of the song, the second Bible reader will come forward and prepare for the reading as printed in your booklet.
Master. a reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. John chapter 14, verse 1 to 6. Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself. So that where I am, there you may be also. And you know the way to the place where I am going. Thomas said to him, Lord, we do not know where we are going. How can we know the way? Jesus said to him, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. We stand now for the singing of the hymn. Number 243, When All Thy Mercies, O My God, My Rising Soul Surveys.
Thank you.
Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. Please be seated. We have gathered here this evening to join and to offer our condolences, our blessings to the friends, family of our departed sister, Faith. And as we join in this service of praise and thanksgiving for her life, work, and witness, Faith loved many things. But she loved above all else her Savior. She was a pleasant woman, but she realized that being enough was not good enough to go to heaven. I once heard the story of a young girl who walked through a cemetery every night because it was the shortest route to her home. When asked why she had no fear of walking through or passing through the graveyard, she responded this, and I quote, "The reason I'm not afraid, my home is just on the other side," end of quote. I believe that many of you here would have had those moments of walking through the cemetery. And back then, I believe that we might have been a little bit more afraid than now, but certainly, if we ever thought about it, our home is on the very side of the cemetery or the graveyard that we have walked through. This evening, my friends in Christ, we have gathered to celebrate the life of a woman who has made her way home over to the other side, like the young girl said in the short story. St. Paul wrote, "My desire is to depart and be with Christ." Philippians chapter 1 and verse 23. "To die is to gain, but I live on in the flesh, and this will mean fruit from my labor. Yet what shall I choose? I cannot tell, for I am hard pressed between the two, having a desire to depart and be with Christ, which is far better. Nevertheless, to remain in the flesh is more needful for you." And those are the extended versions of Philippians chapter 1, verses 21 to 23. Sobered by the possibility of dying, weary of the stresses of this life, Paul acknowledged that he would welcome the rest death brings in some ways. Since all conscious thought ceases upon death, Ecclesiastes chapter 9 and verse 5, and the righteous remain in the grave until their resurrection at the return of Christ, 1 Thessalonians 4:16, he would be with Christ in his next waking moment. However, recognizing the need for his continued service to the church at Philippi, Paul believed that he would not die before seeing the members there again. There are many who through the ages have tried to distort the scripture to say that Paul expected to go to heaven to be with Christ the instant he had died. But it says nothing about going to heaven. Further, interpreting Paul's words, this would conflict with the rest of Scripture, which reveals that Christians do not go to heaven upon death. It is for this reason that we often hear the words like, in the nearer presence of Jesus Christ our Lord, or at peace with the Lord, or at rest in the Lord. We all must await the second advent of our King to be finally with him in heaven. For her family members to live on, it will comfort them. But to be in the nearer presence of Jesus Christ, the Lord, it means peace and rest. No more crying, no more pain. No more of the world's troubles on your back. Rather, faith is now in that place, in the nearer presence of Jesus Christ, our Lord. And all the things of this life are no longer hers. They are for us who live on after today. And there is a song, I believe, that most of you may know it. And if you do know it, I would like you to sing along with me. And it goes like this. You are my sunshine, my only sunshine. You make me happy when skies are gray. You'll never know, dear, how much I love you. Please don't take. The sunshine, my brothers and sisters in Christ, that we all had in our departed sister Faye, has been taken away. That sunshine that we had in Faye is now in the nearer presence of Jesus Christ, our Lord. And we say now, in these final moments, to God be the glory. The sunshine that we had in our sister Faye, that made us happy when the skies were gray, we're now being encouraged to look to someone else who still will make us happy, though she's gone from us in the body. And I'm inviting you this evening, as we go on, to look to Jesus. As someone once noted, she may have lived her last moments forgetting or remembering memories and faces, but she has never forgotten her Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. For Jesus was the center of her life, and her children being a close second in place. Anyone who knew Faye knew she was a pleasant person, an interesting woman, and an outdoor person, and loved many things of this life. I first met our departed sister working at Matt's Garment Factory, and I can see some of those faces from Matt's here this evening. The gentleman who was the repairman of the sewing machines, he's standing at the door, and there are a few others who are here with us. And all the staff and the owners of Matt's Garment Factory were my good friends. And on the 1st of October, 2020, when I made my first Sunday morning here in this church, Faye greeted me, I think the second Sunday morning, and she reminded me of our time together as I shared with the working staff at the garment factory, she being one of them. And I perhaps would say to you this evening that as I met that same friendliness and warmth at Matt's Garment Factory through our departed sister, I met the same as I came here and as she greeted me with that joy and that spark in her eyes. Sometimes when people die, we ask the question, who will go to heaven? And we are never sure. Even although they may have been the best of persons with a good spirit, as our departed sister was, one who hardly missed church. And from Sunday after Sunday, making her walk down Cleaver's Hill week by week with her dear friend Claudine. A woman full of energy each week. And about three Sunday evenings before she was called home to be in the nearer presence of Jesus Christ, our Lord, as I was coming down the hill, I met herself and Claudine coming down, and I stopped and I said to them, would you all like a ride or would you like to walk? And of course, they took the ride. And when we were coming down the hill, she remarked this to me, and I'm not blowing a trumpet this evening, I'm trying to make a point. And our reflection as I thought back over these past weeks, reflecting on her death, I thought to myself, who would have known? And perhaps that's the song that's ringing in our ears this evening. Who would have known that she would have gone this quickly? And they both remarked to me as we were making the journey down the hill, we are always looking forward to your messages on Sunday morning. And you always give us something to think about during the week, and we are looking forward for that even today. And after Faye said those words, Claudine then turned and said, true, true, that is true. We're looking forward to something. I always give you a word to go home with on Sunday mornings. And please excuse the dialect, but that's the conversation we were having. And after that, two Sundays before she did not come back out to church, it was interesting. Our departed sister came to the altar to receive a blessing. And when I asked her, do you need a special blessing today? She said to me, no, just a general blessing. And perhaps I can say on hindsight, no, who knows? That might have been for her last blessing. Knowing full well that her time on this earth was coming to an end. And I want to say this evening, as I have shared that short story with you, that it is important for all of us to recognize the goodness of God, one, to recognize how important people are to us whilst they're still alive, because once they're dead and gone, they're no more help to us apart from their spirit resting over us. It says to each and every one of us that those that we have with us as we live on in this life, we need to cherish them, to hold them dear, to respect them, to care for them, and to look out for them. For we never, ever know which day will be the last. And because of the presence of our Lord's life, of our Lord, in the life of our departed sister. I want to say to all of you this evening that the presence of the Lord in and upon our lives brings us peace. A peace that we have heard from the very St. Paul that passes all understanding. And none of us may not know. We cannot begin to comprehend the nature of that peace. And it was as a result of all of that peace, our sister was able to depart this life in the quietness and in the solitude with her Lord and Master, Jesus Christ. If there are those of us who believe that God is not good, I'm charging you this evening to recognize it. I'm charging you more to know it. And I'm charging you more to find it and to find him. Seek him while he may be found and call upon him while he's near. Draw near to God and he will draw near to you. And when we flee from God, he will flee from us. Our departed sister in Christ knew the Bible well enough to recognize that God brings peace, that God brings hope, and that God gives more strength. And those very attributes of God are what I am commending to you, her friends and her family, as you mourn. She knew that none of us are good enough to deserve heaven. She would know that all of us, as you have known, have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. And that none of us are good enough to be enough to earn salvation. The only hope that we have is in Jesus Christ, our Lord. And we hear the words of affirmation this evening from St. John chapter 14. Jesus said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life, and no one comes to the Father except through me." And this concept for many is puzzling. But I want to explain it this evening in these simple words. At most funerals, and this evening being no exception to the rule, there are flowers that friends and family have purchased to express their love for the dearly beloved and the dearly departed. Some of these are cut flowers, and if you gaze your eyes on the casket, those flowers are cut flowers. And they are perhaps the most beautiful because there are a collection of colors which form a particular shape for the casket. There are others that are simple plants, but beautiful and elegant in their own way. And from time to time, there are funerals where persons will plant a plant into the grave so that it can grow and blossom, a reminder and a testimony of the life of the departed. This bouquet on the casket this evening, though beautiful and elegant, it was purchased because of its beauty. And let us say that the family were to say to me that I could take this bouquet this evening. I wouldn't, but to make the point, let's say that they say that I can take the bouquet and I can take it home. And I will take the bouquet home. I can put these flowers in a vase or I can leave them as they are. And I can water them every day. But in another week's time, what will they look like? They would be dead. But if I took home a plant that was brought this evening for the funeral, a plant with roots in a pot, sister, in another week or month's time, it would still be alive. And you will ask yourself, what is the difference? The plant has roots. These flowers have no roots. These flowers have no fruit that gives us life. The plant has roots. It will grow, and perhaps, if it is a flowering plant, it will blossom into something fruitful until the roots die. In the same way, my brothers and sisters in Christ, it is our root in Jesus Christ, our Lord, thanks be to God, that gives us life. And if our lives, if our hope, if our full being, our soul, our spirit is not planted and rooted and grounded in Jesus Christ, nothing in this life. And this is the truth that we all must understand. And it challenges us more and more every day to ask the question, where is my life rooted and grounded? Is it grounded in the material things of this life? Is it grounded in the illusions of this life? And I'm charging you again this evening, you who remain, that if you desire to bear fruit, and bear fruit that will last, we need to find our hope and our strength and our lives rooted and grounded in Jesus Christ, our Lord. And that is why we often hear the words of this song. And that is why so many love this song. Maybe a simple hymn. And again, I would like you to sing it with me. And it goes like this. Amazing grace, how sweet
the sound that saved a wretch.
And hear what another verse says. When we've been the 10,000 years bright shine,
in the
the life that is rooted and grounded in Jesus Christ, our Lord, bears testimony to the path that we have traveled before and to the path to where God has brought us to and the path that God would lead us to as long as we remain faithful in Him. And even at our dying bed, because we have been faithful to the Lord our God, we can still continue to sing His praises to the end. God at the beginning and God at the end. We then, my brothers and sisters in Christ, cannot simply earn a place in heaven, but because of Jesus Christ, our Lord, we can receive what we never deserved. And it is in our acts of becoming Christian that God drives that true form to us. Through our baptism, God has given us two promises. One, that our sins are buried in the grave and will never be remembered again. And two, that just as we rise from the grave, from the water of the life of baptism, when Jesus returns for us, there will be no grave that can hold us. We will rise from the dead to be with Him forever. Without Jesus Christ, our Lord, the grave is a locked door. But with Jesus Christ, our Lord, thanks be to God, that door is just a passageway into an eternity with God. Today then, as we say farewell to our departed sister in Christ, we give God thanks for her work, her life, and her witness. We thank God for all that she has been to all of us who have encountered her. And certainly, she, like countless others who have gone before us, have left footprints in the sands of time. We thank her for her love, for her caringness, for her sharing, for her words of exhortation, for her words of comfort, for her words of encouragement, and above all else, we thank God for her strength. A life to be emulated. A life to be carried on by those of you who are left behind. And more so, as our sister lived in the faith, she died in the faith. And it was through her time here with us, week by week, that she knew what the Lord God was to her. I say to you this evening, I recommend her Lord and my Lord and our Lord to you. And I urge you, like the songwriter says, I will never forget His mercies. I recommend my Lord to you. May God in Christ Jesus our Lord keep you going forward in faith, in hope, and in the strength and power of His might. May He sustain you with His presence and His peace. And may He be for each and every one of you a source of comfort as we traverse the valley of the shadow of death. May God in Christ continue to bless all of you. And may you evermore remember the eternal God is your refuge, and underneath are the everlasting arms. On behalf of the congregational family here at St. Joseph and St. Aidan, We take this opportunity to extend to you, family and relatives and our friends, our deepest condolences as you mark the passing of our beloved sister, Faye. And I invite you to remember, be not dismayed. Whatever betide, God will take care of you. In the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit, amen. We stand now and we sing the hymn. Creator of the world, to thee, number 113. Let us pray as we continue with the intercessions as printed on page 10 of your booklet, and please remain standing for the prayers. Let us pray. Almighty God, you have knit together your chosen people in one communion, in the mystical body of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Give to your whole church in heaven and on earth your light and your peace. May all who have been baptized into Christ's death and resurrection die to sin and rise to newness of life. And may we with him pass through the grave and gate of death to our joyful resurrection. Grant to us who are still in our pilgrimage, and all who walk as yet by faith, that your Holy Spirit may lead us in holiness and righteousness all our days. Grant to your faithful people pardon and peace, that we may be cleansed from all our sins and serve you with a quiet mind. Grant to all who mourn a sure confidence in your loving care, that casting all their care on you, they may know the consolation of your love. Give courage and faith to those who are bereaved, that they may have strength to meet the days ahead in the comfort of a holy and a certain hope, and in the joyful expectation of eternal life with those they love. Let us bow our heads in prayer. Lord Jesus Christ, we commend to you our sister Faye, who was reborn by water and the Spirit in holy baptism. Grant that her death may recall to us your victory over death and be an occasion for us to renew our trust in your Father's love. Give us, we pray, the faith to follow where you have led the way and where you live and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit, through Christ our Lord. The hymn now, number 476, The King of Love, My Shepherd Is. And during the singing of this hymn, a collection will be taken for the ongoing ministry of the church.
Dust, you shall return. All of us go down to the dust,
Yet even at the grave we make our song, Hallelujah, Hallelujah, Hallelujah.
Give rest, O Christ, to your servant, and his sorrow and pain are no more. Let us sign, but life everlasting.
Lord, have mercy upon us.
Christ, have mercy upon us.
Lord, have mercy upon us.
Christ, have mercy.
Our Father in heaven,
hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
Let us commend our sister Faith to the mercy of God, our Maker and Redeemer. Deliver your servant Fair, O sovereign Lord Christ, from all evil, and set her free from every bond, that she may rest with all your saints in the eternal habitations, where with the Father and the Holy Spirit you live and reign, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Into your hands, O merciful Savior, we commend your servant Fair. Acknowledge, we humbly beseech you, a sheep of your own fold, a lamb of your own flock, a sinner of your own redeeming. Receive her into the arms of your mercy, in the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and into the glorious company of the saints in light, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Rest eternal grant to her, O Lord.
And let light perpetual shine upon her.
May she and all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace.
Amen.
Hallelujah, Christ is risen.
The Lord is risen indeed. Hallelujah.
Let us go forth in the name of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
The God of peace, who brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus Christ, the great shepherd of the sheep, through the blood of the everlasting covenant, make you perfect in every good work to do his will. I'm working in you that which is well-pleasing in his sight, through Jesus Christ, to whom belong glory forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
We join and sing the closing hymn, Now Thank We All Our God, to be followed by the Nunc Dimittis.
Oh, man. trumpet of the Lord shall sound, and time shall be no more, and the morning breaks eternal bright and fair. When the saved of earth shall gather over on the other shore, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there.
When the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there.
When the roll
is called up yonder, I'll be there.
When the roll
is called up yonder.
When the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there.
On that bright and cloudless morning, when the dead in Christ shall rise, and the glory of his resurrection share, when his chosen ones shall gather to their home beyond the skies, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there.
When the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there.
When the roll
is called up yonder, I'll be there.
When the roll
up yonder.
When the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there.
Traveling are over. Not a shadow, not a sigh. For the day of rejoicing that will be when we all see Jesus. We'll sing and shout the victory.
Let us then be true and faithful, trusting, serving every day. Just one glimpse of Him in glory will the toils of life repay. When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see Jesus, we'll sing and shout the victory. Onward to the prize before us, soon His beauty gates will open. We shall tread the streets of gold. When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see Jesus.
Blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine. Heir of salvation, purchase of God, born of His Spirit, washed in His blood.
Praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story, this is my song. Praising my Savior, perfect submission, perfect delight. Visions of rapture now burst on my sight. Angels descending, ring from above. This is my song,
at rest. I in my Savior am happy and blessed, watching and waiting, looking above.
This is my story, this is my song. Praising my Savior.
Anyone the Father gives to me will come to me. I will never turn away anyone who believes in me. He who raised Jesus Christ from the dead will also give new life to our mortal bodies through his indwelling spirit. My heart therefore is glad and my spirit rejoices. My body also shall rest in hope. You will show me the path of life. In your presence there is fullness of joy, and in your right hand are pleasures forevermore. I heard a voice from heaven saying, write this, happy are the dead who die in the faith of Christ. Henceforth, says the Spirit, they may rest from their labors, for they take with them the record of their deeds. Man born of a woman has but a short time to live. Like a flower, he blossoms and then withers. Like a shadow, he flees and never stays. In the midst of life, we are in death. To whom can we turn for help? But to you, Lord, who are justly angered by our sins. Lord God, holy and mighty, holy and immortal, holy and most merciful Savior, deliver us from the bitter pains of eternal death. You know the secrets of our hearts. In your mercy, hear our prayer. Forgive us our sins, and at our last hour, let us not fall away from you. In sure and a certain hope of resurrection to eternal life, through our Lord Jesus Christ, we commend to Almighty God our sister Faye Antoinette, and we commit her body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, and dust to dust. And we beseech you in your infinite goodness to give us grace to live in your dear love and to die in your favor, that when your well-beloved Son shall come again in judgment, both this, our sister, Faye Antoinette, and we ourselves may be found acceptable in your sight. Grant this for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. With you. Let us bow our heads in prayer. Almighty God, with whom still live the spirits of those who die in the Lord, and with whom the souls of the faithful are in joy and felicity, we give you heartfelt thanks for the good examples of all your servants who, having finished their course in faith, now find a rest and a refreshment. May we, before who have died in the true faith of your holy name, have perfect fulfillment and bliss in your eternal and everlasting glory, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Merciful God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who is the resurrection and the life, raise us, we humbly pray, from the death of sin to the life of righteousness, that when we depart this life, we may rest in him, and at the resurrection receive that blessing which your well-beloved Son shall then pronounce. Come, you blessed of my Father, receive the kingdom prepared for you. Grant this, O merciful Father, through Jesus Christ, our mediator and redeemer. Amen. Grant, O Lord, courage, that you may have the strength to meet the days to come with steadfastness and patience, not sorrowing as those without hope, but in thankful remembrance of God's great goodness, and in the joyful expectation of eternal life with those you love. And this we ask in the name of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Rest eternal grant to her, O Lord. May she and all the faithful departed through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. Amen. The Lord bless her and keep her. The Lord make his face to shine upon her and evermore be gracious unto her. May the Lord lift up the light of his countenance upon her and give her peace, now and forevermore. Amen. When the trumpet of the Lord shall sound, and time shall be no more. When the morning breaks, eternal, bright and clear. When the saved on earth shall gather over on the other shore, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. The hymn, when the trumpet of the Lord shall sound.
Thank you.
again to all the champion scenes of pain, in trouble and in joy. The praises of my God shall still my heart and tongue employ.
Of glory divine. our salvation, purchase of God, born of His Spirit, washed in His blood.
Bow our heads in prayer. Merciful Father and Lord of all life, we praise you that men and women are made in your image and reflect your light and your truth. We thank you for the life of your daughter Faye, for the love of mercy she received from you and showed among us. Above all, we rejoice at your gracious promise to all your servants, living and departed, that we shall rise again at the coming of Christ. And we ask that in due time we may share with our sister that clearer vision when we shall see your face in the name of Christ our Lord. Amen. Remember, O Lord, this your servant who has gone before us with the sign of faith and now rests in the sleep of peace. According to your promises, grant to her and to all who rest in Christ, refreshment, light, and peace. And may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all, now and forevermore. Amen. Amen. Accompanied by the recorded music, we shall sing our final hymn as the floral tributes are laid. What a fellowship, what a joy divine, leaning on the everlasting arms.